Hello, everybody. Welcome to Morning English. This is Blair.
Hi, guys. This is Cici. 欢迎大家收听早安英文。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
三人行，必有我师焉。择其善者而从之，其不善者而改之。
谢谢，这是在干嘛呢？背诵文言文啊。
Yeah, 保持学习，天天向上。哎，贝贝啊，你别说，我刚刚呢在读这句话的时候啊，就想到了之前有学员问过我，哎，三个人到底是应该用 three people 还是用 three persons?
Well, that's a very good question. We should check the explanation in the dictionary first. So person 在词典当中的解释是这样的。A human being, especially considered as someone with their own particular character.
那就是说啊 ,person 强调的呢是个体，尤其是指单个人啊，某个人有指定性，可以是指呢 man, woman, 或者是 child 当中的任何一个啊。
Yeah, and let's see people. So it's used as a plural of person to refer to men, women, and children.
那这个解释就很清晰啦，是说 people 啊可以来表示 person 的复数形式，强调的是群体，指的是这一群人，对吧？
Right, 所以 three persons 和 three people 表达都没有问题啊，主要是看在语境当中强调的对象。比如说他们三个人放学后啊经常一起打羽毛球，有具体指这三个人，我们就用three persons. He three persons often play badminton after school.
而换一个语境啊，比如说像事故类型的新闻报道当中啊，经常会有说至少造成三人死亡，那这里的三人表示就是一个整体，用 three people. For example, it killed at least three people and also injured three firefighters.
Exactly. 那关于 person 和 people 口语当中呢，还有一些很好玩的使用表达搭配啊。So how about we talk about it in today's podcast?
Great, let's do it.
Okay, so Cici, I think you are a people person. You're warm and friendly.
All right, warm and friendly. I got that. But what does people person mean? 我是个人?
Of course, yes. 首先是个人啊。
Okay.
So people person refers to someone who is particularly gregarious, affable, or outgoing. Someone with great interpersonal communication skills.
People person 还有这个意思啊，就是形容特别合群、和蔼可亲，或者说外向的人，以及呢有很好的人际沟通技巧的人。That's me.
确实是你啊。那当我们想表达自己有点社恐，不太擅长社交的时候呢，我们也可以用这个表达来说。So I'm not a people person.
Okay. 贝贝啊，我还想到个好玩的。Third person, 第三个人，他是不是可以表达我们说的感情中的第三者呀？
Well, no. Third person shows that someone is speaking or writing about another person. To simplify this, it tells a story using pronouns he or she.
也就是说 third person 是指的第三人称这个意思。
Yeah, for example, the novel alternates between a third narrative and notes taken from a court case.
Yeah, 这句话的意思是说，这本小说呢是在第三人称叙事和法庭案件笔记之间交替进行的。
对，那顺便就和大家拓展一下这个第三者的正确说法。
Okay.
下面这几种都可以。首先 Mistress, M-I-S-T-R-E-S-S. It refers to a woman that a man has a sexual relationship with, even though he is married to someone else. 也就是我们说的情妇、第三者这个意思。
Mistress.它是指的女生是小三的时候啊，那男生其实也可以成为小三嘛。我们可以用 home wrecker， 它就没有这个性别的一个区分了。Wrecker， W-R-E-C-K-E-R， wrecker means someone who deliberately destroys something. Home wrecker 呢，就是说的破坏家庭的人。In my opinion, it is immoral to become a homewrecker.
That's true. 第三者其实就是说婚姻或者恋情当中两个人之外的另一个人啊。所以 third person 就不对，但是可以使用 the other man, the other woman.
All right. So Blair,、
mm-hmm.
you are now a total morning person.
Yeah, you're right. 每天早上七点的经济学人外刊阅读课、啊、make me a morning person.
Okay, and a lot of students just become morning persons too because of your class.
Okay, that's glad to hear. 这样每天早上早起给大家上课也就更有动力了啊。所以这里我们说到的 morning person means someone who feels awake and full of energy in the mornings, 也就是早起的人。
I have always been a morning person. I think I work more efficient that way. 那与 morning person 啊对应的就是 night person, 也就是说、啊、夜猫子喜欢熬夜的人对吧、
嗯、现在咱就说零零后的小朋友们应该几乎都是 night person 吧都是夜猫子啊。
零零后的朋友们说勿 Q, thank you. Anyway, night person always find it hard to get up in the mornings.
Yeah, I used to be a night person too.、
Mm?
I just think I can be so much more productive when there's no one else awake.
Okay, 可能是因为我付不起最贵的面膜，我就不熬这么贵的夜了。 Okay, so Blair, are you a last minute person?
Well, no, I like to finish things when it's far away from deadline.
Wow, that's cool. I was a complete last minute person when I was a student. 我以前啊，真的是直到马上要到 deadline 的时候啊，那种紧张感会让我很兴奋，让我效率翻倍，而且那个时间点完成啊，你会有一种成就感，
就觉得自己棒呆了，是吧？
Yeah, but when it comes to work, it's different. 工作呢，就不得不让人成为一个有规划、更高效的人。
Yeah, 所以 a last minute action is one that is done at the latest time possible. 就是 last minute 的行为，就是尽可能在晚的时间完成啊。
嗯，
那 last minute person 我们可以理解为临时抱佛脚的人，有拖延症的人，不到某个时间啊，绝对不做那件事的人。
Well, that reminds me one of my friends.、
Mm-hmm.
She's a typical last minute person. She doesn't finish her work until the last minute. 她呢就是个典型的拖延症患者了，直到最后一分钟啊才完成工作，而且和她出去玩啊，她也这样。
所以你朋友听到我们这期节目，应该也会说勿 Q 啊，栓 Q。哎，你朋友会听节目吗？
我这不是没说名字吗？所以这个时候我的朋友们应该会想，我和 Cici 不是朋友。
OK, 那举个例子而已啊。最后呢，我们再来看一个 little people.People mean small imaginary creatures, such as leprechauns that look like small men, and it also refers to all the people in a country organization who have no power.
Yeah, little people.不能够按咱们字面的意思上来理解，说很少的人啊，它有两个意思，一个是小精灵、小人儿。比如说 ，Last night I had a dream about the little people of fairy tales， 就是说啊，我昨晚梦见了童话故事里面的小精灵，这个意思。
对，另外就是指的小人物啊，比如这个例句 ：When it comes to the selection of president, we need someone that's fighting for the little people.
Yeah.OK, 那今天我们学了这么多 people 和 person 的实用表达，大家就赶紧学起来用起来吧。
Yeah, and that's all we have for today.
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
So, thank you so much for listening. This is Cici.
This is Blair. See you next time.
Bye.